of evidence is Pam talking about different spirits that are down in the office downstairs. And if you look to her right, you can see an orb shoot across and then come back and fade out.
Laugh, he likes to tell jokes and stuff like that. Most of the time, he'll
And Pam is asking for one of the spirits to step forward, and if you look on the K2 meter, you can see an orb come across the top.
Come on, you can do it. You want to hear me squeal again? Come on, you can do it.
I've never seen an orb like this. It's very bright. It's down at the bottom going through the doorway, and there's two or three people in the doorway. It's very bright. It's not a bug. It's not a reflector. It's not a firefly. Don't know what it is. I've slowed it down several times and tried to take a look at it. It just moves really quickly. Just pay attention and you'll see. And here we have another orb downstairs in front of the bathroom at the end of the hall.
Then I'll get all excited and get disappointed when I find out for sure.
Into the electrical room downstairs, where the original footings of the house are. You can hear a couple of people talking about what's going on, what they thought they heard, something's going on. And you hear a voice that says, sure. Sounds like a male voice, but it's no one that's in our group.
Sure.
Got it, Liz. Close the staircase.
Sure.
Got it, Liz.
We're now in the safe room, and Brian is getting spikes on the male meter. If you look to the bottom right-hand side of the screen, you'll see an orb, and it's very fascinating to me that you're having a male spike and an orb at the same time.
0.3, 0.4,
there's somebody in here knocking
0.6.
That door.
Point 0.6 on the...
On that door that you're right from.
0.3. Mm-hmm. 0.4.
There's somebody in here knocking
0.6.
That door.
We're now in the safe room. And Brian is getting spikes on the mail meter. If you look to the bottom right-hand side of the screen, you'll see an orb. And it... Very fascinating to me that you're having a male spike and an orb at the same time.
Did anybody just go back or push the door? The door just popped.
Did it?
Yeah. You heard it, right?
I mean, I heard it, but I just,
I heard it.
You know.
You don't pay no attention to it, but nobody was on it.
Because, well,
there's just always noises going, you know?
Right, yeah, you don't pay any attention to it, but if you... The door just it popped up against her.
Point
1.3. No, I just touched the door.
No, that meter.
You can't make the meter go all the time.
Oh, no, I'm saying it.
And about 3 seconds after they get the knock on the door and the male spike, they get this. It's pretty self-explanatory.
It just keeps...
chair's moving.
Oh, yeah. Anybody touch the door? No, was anybody touching the door?
No.
No.
Nobody touching the door, period.
I love this. All right, we hear you. Come on.
We are now upstairs on the third floor, and we're in the main hallway. Everybody's kind of spread out to get some breathing room. Joe is off in front of the main staircase to the house that's closed off the doors. And from the old office, you see an orb come through and join everyone in the main hallway. Right after the orb came out of the hallway next to Joe, I mean immediately afterwards, someone, Pam, hears a growl, and you can hear underneath the conversations a small growl. But this is immediately after that orb came out of the office and came through the hallway is when they heard this.
Did you hear that?
We were here. We were hearing pain.
Wow, did y'all start that?
Yeah.
I did.
We were hearing pain, like, pens dropping.
2.5.
Did you hear that?
We were here. We were hearing pain.
Wow, did y'all start that?
Yeah. I did.
We were hearing pain, like, pens dropping.
Now, still on the third floor, after they heard the growl and tracked around, tried to find out where that could be coming from, you can see an orb heading to the doorway that goes to the balcony. This is immediately after they heard the growl. You have an orb come out of the office with Joe, come down the hallway. You hear the growl, and then the orb disappears. Very interesting. All three of these things happen within a 3-minute time period, and I've broken it up so that you can hear and see each individual thing.
Okay, well, he didn't get here. He didn't get over here.
Still up on the third floor, we're gathering up, about ready to go back downstairs. Brian gets a millimeter spike, and you can see right next to Joe, there's a fast-moving light. It's not reflecting off of anything. We're in the dark, but you'll have to watch it. It's right next to Joe, and you'll see it just streak across the wall when Brian is giving the count of the millimeter.
Very tall.
I guess I'm spotting 5.4.
Very tall.
I guess I'm spotting 5.4.
Very tall.
I guess I'm spotting 5.4.
Very tall.
And we're downstairs getting ready to pack up everything for the night. Brian wanted to go downstairs for one last final sweep. You can see that he's standing in front of the doorway. He says, wait, come back. And you'll see an orb come to him, circle in front of him, and go back down the hallway. There's a male spike seen by Brian, and also seen by Taylor on the steps. Then Brian moves forward into the office, and he sees what he said was a full-body apparition, and it scares him. He runs and leaves. Enjoy this clip.
7?
It's 7.7. Hey, Wallace. Wait, come back. I want to talk to you. I'm not here to hurt you. Charlie? You want to come near me? You want to come touch me?
Byron, are you down here? You want to go down? We can go down.
I just can't see crap. Okay, there we go.
Anyone here? Anyone want to talk?
Go, go, go! Go, go! Go!
I was saying that I just see 0.7.
It's 0.7. Wait, come back. I want to talk to you. I'm not here to hurt you.